Hey guys, Stealth here. It's been a while, and I gotta say, it's been a lot longer than I had hoped, and the reason for that is that I had a pretty severe case of the flu, and when that happens, I start coughing like a crazy person. My voice goes all weird, I can barely speak at my normal volume, and this caused me to take pretty much a two-week break from recording YouTube videos, so that is why I haven't been active. What I have been doing in the off time is trying to get through XCOM, and that is exactly what we're looking at today. Now, the A Better Advent 2 mod for XCOM 2 makes this game very, very difficult. And the mod developer especially stated that if you are running this mod, then initially, if you only use a 4-man squad, you're gonna have a very, very bad time. It is going to make it very, very, very difficult. So he recommends that initially you up the level of your soldiers in your unit to 6 or 8. Now, I have been running tests on both. If I run 6 soldiers, I tend to still get overwhelmed. If I run 8, the game becomes somewhat doable. Now, normally you cannot even get 8 soldiers, but with the Long War mod pack, you can exactly do that. You can set a default squad size. I'm gonna go for 8, and this means that with the upgrades from the guerrilla tactics school that I'm already building, I can even further upgrade that to 10. Now, those are very, very sizable squads, but here's the thing. The A Better Advent 2 mod increases the amount of soldiers in an enemy alien pod per the amount of soldiers in your armory or in your group. So if I have an 8-man squad, I'm going to see either more pods or bigger pods, making it more difficult. Now, with that in mind, building the guerrilla tactics school immediately is probably not the best idea. I'd need more soldiers. I have 2 people out of commission, 1 is fatigued. This means I just have 4 rookies, and trust me, that is not anywhere near enough. So what I'm going to do,
give the word and I'll get started,
and this is something that I don't usually do, I'm going to go with the guerrilla tactics school, and I'm not going to build it. I am going to cancel this structure, which is something I really don't like to do. The thing that I'm doing it for is so that I can get a few more soldiers. There we go. Stop construction. Now I have 90 supplies, so I can get 3 new soldiers from the armory.
You lived in one of the colonies and for a few years before linking up with the
most important
right?
thing is just yes, getting through these first few missions. That is by far the most important aspect.
But there was a price.
Anyway, new soldiers. I have one pretty damn good Zoe King operative here. And yes, I will be renaming some of these operators to suit your names, the ones that you submitted in one of the previous videos.
Quite like providing identification.
Zoe King is on board. Zoe King was very good at accuracy and pretty good at staying alive, but her mental fortitude, her willpower, not that good. That is something that I found to be a problem, even if you're using 8-man squads. If you have, for example, an 8-man squad consisting of mostly rookies, and one of them gets hit or one of them dies, then it's not unlikely for 3 or 4 others to panic. It's that bad. So high willpower is also a very important element here. Last one I'm going to go with Zoe Lee, 68 accuracy and 44 willpower. She should be alright. That's all I have money for. So, let's go into the globe and have a look at what other missions are currently available. Unfortunately, I spawned in Asia, which is not ideal. Asia is a bit unfortunate because it has 4 zones, and that means that you cannot quickly get the continent bonus. Anyway, we'll see about that as we're going to be dealing with it. This is, by the way, in no way or shape going to be a very easy playthrough. It is going to be extremely, extremely tough. There we go. Modular weapons is online.
Though it is intriguing.
Yes, except I'm going to go for biotech first. I want to try and rush alien or correction resistance comms, so that with that I can make sure that I have the capacity of reaching out to new areas and up my income, because my income will be very important. you might even say more so. Oh, look, we got Austin Powers. It might be even more important after seeing the fact that soldiers die a lot. So I'm probably going to have to buy some new soldiers.
Avenger plotting.
Now, with a good
course.
Supply of rookies, I should be fine for a while. First, going to pick up some supplies, and I wouldn't be surprised if we're going to get surprised or if we're going to get. There we go. The first guerrilla ops mission. It's going to get me an engineer. Exactly what I was hoping for. Need to hack the hidden resistance computer. Let's do it.
Setting course for the Indian Regional Zone.
There is my full 8-man squad. I'm going to clear the squad. I'm going to see who's available for the more advanced team. Unfortunately, that's only my gunner. The other two are still gravely wounded or otherwise unavailable. So Shane Elliott is going to be my most level soldier at Squatty. The rest of it doesn't really matter. See, normally I would try and take these soldiers first into the guerrilla tactics school to train them up, and thereby making sure that they're at least at rookie and that they have a specialization. That's no longer possible, because I won't have a guerrilla tactics school anytime soon. I mean, sure, it's going to be a priority, but I cannot guarantee that it's something that I'll be able to build quickly. Now, upgrade equipment. What do we have? Yeah, we have one stock. One stock only. So I'm going to have to try and find the soldier that is the worst at hitting targets and making sure that they can actually hit something. What the hell is up with your hair? We are not having that. That's a little better. You're just going to get a man bun, and I really don't like your glasses either. Hippie glasses, get out of here. There. Now at least you resemble something like an operator with your orange vest. Something else that I mentioned in the previous episode of XCOM was that I was going to go with squads. Squads provide bonuses if you always have the same soldiers in the same pack. Again, that is something that I pretty much cannot guarantee. Reason being that most of the time, soldiers will be spending in the hospital. Meaning that a soldier is unavailable and that a soldier cannot operate in his standard squad. Anyway, this is what we have. This is what we have to go with. So let's just get started. Because that's what you're here for, right? To see me mess up in XCOM.
Ranger, squad green to deploy.
A hacker trying to impress the resistance found a way into the Advent network through an access point near our AO from the Union's latest operation. Unfortunately, she only lived long enough to recover a fragment of the data. We're moving to secure the area, eliminate any alien forces nearby, and hack that terminal before they manage to lock it down. We need that data if we're going to stop their progress.
Now, normally you'd only have about 7 turns to get there before the computer shuts down. This time around, I have the better concealment, or the true concealment, making it so that I can get there in as much time as I need.
Menace 1-5, this is Avenger. The access point we're after is just ahead.
One pod right next
move
to it.
To secure the area. Expect hostile resistance.
Now, you may be arguing, why haven't I actually gone in and changed my soldiers a bit? Why haven't I customized them? Well, because I am absolutely convinced that not all of these boys will be coming home. I'm going to be, or correction, boys and girls. I still have some female operators in here. I'm going to be doing my best to make sure that they get home in one piece. But it is by no means a guarantee that they all will. Now I'm going to try and get up on this structure. This is going to give me all sorts of height bonuses, both in defending my soldiers from attacks from lower ground and shooting down. So hopefully that'll work. I'm not sure how far the structure extends, but I think this is about it. And I hope to be able to ambush a pod over there. I hope that that's going to be the first one, so I can kill them and then dash towards the computer. Now, contrary to what I normally do in XCOM, the mission is secondary. And that may sound weird. The mission is not the most important aspect. The people are. I want to make sure that my soldiers come home alive. I want to make sure that they level up, which is virtually guaranteed if you have rookies. And getting the mission done would be nice, but if I lose soldiers in the process, then I'm going to be sent back even further. Ah, damn it, this is not what I was hoping for. Four-man pod, a heavy, a riot control, a recon drone, and a trooper. I wonder how far their sight extends upwards. Because I'd rather not get detected right away.
Headed there now.
And XCOM can be a bit wonky where it comes to aliens spawning you sideways through a roof. So these guys are now on the side of the building. Normally you'd say, well, they can only possibly detect you when they're walking around here and spawning something that's sticking out from this little barricade here. Not in XCOM. In XCOM they can spot you through the walls sometimes, and thereby making it very, very unpredictable to see exactly when your soldier is in cover and when he or she is not. I'm going to be dashing a couple of these people up here.
Copy that.
And I think I'm just going to have to cut through this patrol instead of going around it. Going around it would be ideal, but I'm not sure I can do that. I can, however, get up on this roof. But I'm not going to dash there, because one too many times I have managed to get myself into more trouble by dashing from position to position.
Roger, I've got my eyes on.
Not good.
Closing on target position now.
That's so King. That's probably my most accurate operator that I have with me today. Actually, no, Shane Ellie with 75 is probably a little bit more accurate. Yeah, we're gonna put you here.
I'll try not to get too lonely.
That was Sam Fisher right there.
That's
gonna move you to full cover.
Overwatch.
Let's see what that pod is up to. Heading away from my position. That is fortunate. And they are moving towards an explosive vehicle, or a vehicle that can be detonated. That I can use. That I can very, very much use.
Roger.
Don't get spotted, Shane.
Keep quiet or it's bad
news. Shit. There's another pod. Now, you could argue that an 8 versus 8 is doable. Yes and no. If you have some more highly trained operators, then probably. If you're just using rookies, then going up against a pod, or actually two pods, so that's 8 soldiers, is suicide. It is absolutely guaranteed to get shot at. You're absolutely guaranteed to start losing operators because they panic.
Rolling out.
They are simply not trained enough to be able to withstand the fact that they're under fire. Let's see, can I... Yeah, I could get into that structure.
Moving.
Keep Zoe safe from inside. This should also open the way for some of my other operators here. Oh, we got Zoe and Zoe. Oh, well.
10-4.
Now, as for you, I'm not sure where that pod is going to head off to. I don't think that this pod is going to be moving around too much. They seem to be on guard duty there. I cannot exactly get into this structure. There's the door. Alright, we're going to dash you towards this position.
Moving out.
I want you to hold your position. As for Hayim Katz, shit hits the fan and I get detected, they can mostly open up. What you doing? Alright, you're moving away. That's fortunate for the people that are just put indoors. If I can keep those safe, that would be absolutely wonderful. Right. Unfortunately, this is a blind corner. I cannot fire out from there. So this is probably the best spot I have.
Moving to Overwatch.
I'm going to try and set up the ideal ambush, so we're only going to be attacking one pod, that one. Not the other one.
Running.
So if I can have those move out of my line of sight, then that would be a pretty good advantage. Let's see. Have a look
Understood.
Around the corner. Hope that there's nothing there. Nope, nothing there.
Covering now.
Move up just a touch.
Body heals.
I can have you get up the stairs as well. Or I can position you here. This is actually a pretty good spot.
Orders confirmed. On the move.
Mr. Morgan.
Eyes on the prize.
Alright. This is probably not a safe roof anymore. Yeah, I can get up a bit further. But not too much more. I'm slightly concerned that these guys will get up on this roof. So I'm going to prepare for that. And make sure that they don't. Or that if they do, I don't get spotted. Come on, don't be silly, get up here.
Moving to designated position.
Overwatch.
You got it.
Overwatch.
Got my eyes on.
Overwatch. If they do get on the roof, that might even be an advantage. Because if... Nope, they're not going to... If they do get up on the roof, I can throw a grenade and they're going to also take damage as they're dropping down. Right. So they're not coming up. That means that I may have to go down. Or start firing down upon them. And if this group gets attacked, I could probably take this one out in one go. Probably lob a grenade and get some kills. Then this pod is going active. Oh, this is going to get risky. I cannot really turn this into a perfect ambush. Wow, the game was laggy there. What? What?
What a surprise.
Why didn't the game warn me about that? Normally you get all these perfect squares saying, hey, dude, you've been detected. Not today. And this is when operations go entirely sideways. This is when shit hits the fan. Now, fortunately, some of these pods have malfunctioned, so that these three guys are gonna get a grenade. Is that the best use of my soldier? I think so.
Hey, baby.
That's one down. One bit of armor got shredded there. The vehicle is on fire and will detonate. Now, that means that some of these people will have to start moving if they don't want to get shot at. I mean, they're gonna get shot at, but currently Hayim is in a very, very vulnerable position. Jesus, height bonuses are nice, but look at this guy. 62 points of accuracy. Unfortunately, he has the stock, so that helps. And due to the truck, I cannot take out any of these guys. I was hoping to take out the recon drone, because they're pretty damn hard to hit. Alright, go for this recon drone. Nice shooting. Flying elements are always very difficult to hit. There's the first promotion. Now I want to move her just around the corner.
Moving to position.
In case someone does get any funny ideas and get up on the roof. 56. 46. 46. And another 46. Not good. 29. That's worse. What can we use here? I could lob a grenade here. Hoping that I don't take out all the cover. Looks like that the cover can be destroyed. Like that.
Grenade out!
Now the objective here is to kill as many people as possible. That is the primary objective. I don't really worry about spreading out the promotions evenly, because that will sort itself out. I just need to start taking guns of the enemy out of play.
Target neutralized.
That's another promotion right there. Now you are in a very, very troubled position. Gunslingers, by the way, very dangerous troopers, as they have the ability to take a shot at every visible enemy, making it so that they can pretty much engage whoever they like. Again, not good.
I'm trusting you here.
Zoe, I'm going to put you forward. This is why I saved that last bit of cover. Hopefully he... correction, yeah, she can take him out.
Get ready for a surprise!
Got him. Promoted. Sometimes I consider these rookies to be just walking grenade stashes, because that seems to be all that they're good for. I'm gonna put you here.
I'm trusting you here.
I'm gonna put you on Overwatch. And this is the last guy I have. I'm gonna put you on Overwatch as well. If I can lock these people down, that would help. One moving. Got him. That's the drone.
La cible est morte. C'est obligé.
Oh shit. No. Thank you. The guy was already hurt. And that made it so that he was not able to get an accurate shot off. Mind control. This is bad. We have one trooper who's going to park himself behind an exploding vehicle.
Kill! Kill! Kill them all!
You think that's a good idea? I mean, sure, you could try, but I think that my gunner will make short work of that. I was hoping that the vehicle would detonate already, but unfortunately it didn't. Right. So we have a mind-controlled operator. And that means that we need to push forward and get this sectoid out of the way. No high cover anywhere nearby.
Moving out.
If I take out that cover, then I should be able to be taking shots relatively accurately. It won't break his mind control just yet. I'm going to have to take him out completely. There you go. Alright. Free to fire. Target down. Mind control lost.
J'ai tué un ennemi là.
Good. I don't like mind control much. That's a 55% for Zoe Lee there. If I move you up a touch, you should have a perfect shot. Flanking shot, 58% only. Oh, there's the... yeah. That thing is in the way.
Not even close.
Well, it doesn't really matter that much, because he's good as dead anyway. And considering that most of these guys already have a plus next to their name, they're already getting promoted.
If you say so. Got it covered.
In case they're not, we're going to have to put a couple of guys on Overwatch. And I need to start pushing towards that position. I still have 6 turns, which may seem pretty comfortable, but it's really not.
I can handle that.
Zoe, what's your accurate? 51. Take the shot. There you go, good girl.
Impressed yet?
All right. Let's not get too confident here, because that is usually the way that I get a lot of people killed.
What's over there?
And trust me, there's probably at least 3 pods still out there. So that's another 12 alien soldiers that I need to contend with.
Got it covered.
Affirmative. Covering
that is how many pods are usually spawned in. Is that vehicle still... I misestimated. The vehicle is not on fire. I thought the vehicle was sparking, but it's just a bit of flame that's been turned up from the grenade that I launched. Or that I fired. Alright, this is going to be pretty risky.
Moving out.
No problem. No one near.
Come get some.
Okay. I'm going to take a large risk here. I'm thinking
okay.
That there's no pod coming in. If there is, I will get a first shot on them.
Bon, bah, si c'est comme ça.
Whatever you say.
So I'm going to put some of my guys
on my
just on the road to make sure that they at least can get some shots off.
Right. Well, if you say so.
Good to go.
Vigilant,
yeah. Covering now.
On Overwatch.
Lots of people in Overwatch. Oh, my bad. The vehicle did feel like detonating, apparently. And from over here, we should be able to hack the laptop.
Moving to designated position.
Jeff, please do- shit. Company.
I've got eyes on an advent position.
A four-man pod. And there's something else. Shit, he just tripped another two pods. This is bad. This is pretty bad. I can fall back. Because this guy is at severe risk of being flanked by virtually everybody. Which is rather not where
position
I'd like
confirmed.
To have this guy. If possible, take out guys right away. I won't be able to take out the heavy because my grenades always do 3 damage. They never roll for 4. The riot control, probably won't be able to take him out, but I might be able to take out his cover. Yeah, we're gonna go with that.
Boom!
And also apply the bleeding effect. The bleeding effect, in case you're not familiar with it, is the red fog option. That makes soldiers less effective as they're getting more and more hurt. You can hit something for 24% chance. Yeah, not likely. Alright. Do I sacrifice this guy? I'd rather not.
Holding position.
I'm gonna next turn have him hack, and then hunker down.
Stepping off.
Hoping that he's still there next turn. That would be nice. Alright, we can move you up.
What's over there?
Hopefully you can take out the riot control. Yes, that's another one down. Just 7 enemy operators left. Which is still a recipe for disaster. And unfortunately, I don't have high cover. So I'm going to have to either dash towards this position and risk tripping another pod, or dash towards the front where I'm bunching up my soldiers and risking a grenade attack. There are no good options when you're playing XCOM. Aim, you're gonna move towards this position.
Move!
Next up, we have Zoe King and Emile Laurent. The most force seems to be concentrated here. With 2 of them on that end and 1 I don't know about. Who has grenades? You do. I really don't want to trip another pod. I don't really want to dash here either, because I'm thinking that this heavy might push up to this position and start shooting people in the flank. Not good. This then.
Complete.
So that if he moves there, he's gonna get shot at. At least the next turn. I'm gonna try and keep this guy healthy, pretty much at all costs.
Alright, I'm on it.
It's not likely to encounter anyone, but you never know. These scout pods, those... I'm not even sure where they are currently, but those little scanning things, those drones, they're pretty fast. They can get around quickly. Alright, screw it. We're gonna have you duck down. Hunker down. Here comes the sectoid. What's your plan? Going for a mind attack. Panic. Damn it. That usually makes these people do very stupid things. There we go, now he's flanked. Oh, you're just going on Overwatch. Curious choice. He missed.
That all you got?
Could have been way worse. Trooper pushing in. Trooper taking shots and missing my operator. There comes another surveillance drone. This one's heavily armored. He's gonna push himself right next to my Jeff Morgan. And miss. Curious.
Take him heavy fire!
And there's one left, the Advent Trooper. Come on. Okay, I did not take any damage. But I still need to get to my objective. What do we have? We have one guy on Overwatch. Do we have any people with grenades? Not anymore. Or at least not enough. It's a 64, there's a 57. Zoe Lee, you're not even the most accurate shot I have. That's you. Thing is, I'm probably gonna have to fire at this thing twice. Well, let's do it. There you go. So that's 5 damage. That's a high roll.
Not too shabby.
Not too shabby at all. Now, I cannot move. Unfortunately. And I believe... are you the one who has the stock on his weapon? Or is that someone else? Let's see if we can take down more of these drones. Nope. 57% accuracy. Not good enough. Are you exposed? No, you're not, because there's a block in the way. Damn. I'm at severe risk of being flanked here. I hope that this does not... There we go. It did not trigger the Overwatch. Jesus, are you serious?
Not even close.
Yeah.
Hit the armor!
That's what you get for all of that armor. 55%. That's pretty good. You get a bit closer? Well, he could, but I'm not sure if he's gonna hit something. There we go. Thank you.
That did the trick.
That did indeed do the trick. Well done, that. I'm gonna put you in Overwatch. If that guy moves, I might be able to get a shot. This is the last person I have. Sharon Cook. We have 3 turns until that thing shuts down. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 enemy operators. That we know of. Move up just a touch. You have a shot. It's only a 32%. I'm gonna take that.
Covering now.
I'm gonna try and have him move. What are you gonna do, sectoid? Shit. There's another mind attack. He's gonna mind control Zoe King again? No, he's going for the Revenant. The Revenant Rises attack.
No respite for the dead. The aliens have found a way to mind control them now.
shit. I think she panicked. Uh-oh. Bloody hell. He wasn't even hunkered down anymore. Ooh. That knocked down half the wall.
There's heavy fire in this zone.
What are you gonna do, trooper? Don't overwatch, please. And he missed again. There's another bit of wall gone.
All right.
Panic removed. Sharon Cook is actually alive and not panicked. Which is pretty impressive for a rookie. Normally these people just freak out at every opportunity they get, but she actually held in there. I'm gonna have to go for the network shutdown. Because I really like to get that engineer. If only to start excavating my ship. Oh wow, that actually got pretty high as well.
We've got access.
We've confirmed successful acquisition of the Advent files.
They have no one on Overwatch.
In the area.
That can be a real problem for them.
Okay, j'y vais.
We have a perfect shot on him, but I really want to get the sectoid. That is a far more dangerous adversary. And he's now completely exposed. You have a shot at the sectoid. And that's my wounded operator. I want to take out the sectoid so that the zombie goes down automatically. Wow. Someone give her a medal. That was good. Alright, apparently I somehow managed to mess up the loot in the sense that it's no longer there.
I can handle that.
I probably detonated it with one of my soldiers, so just completely didn't pay attention to that. Bloody hell, that was a high roll.
Did you see that one?
Well done, Zoe. Alright, we got Christina, we got Zoe Lee, Shane, and Hayim. There should be a pretty simple solution here.
Moving.
Start wiping out people on the flanks. Goodbye.
Taken care of.
We got something resembling high cover here.
Okay, I'll go.
49%. It's pretty good. I'm gonna take it. No, I shouldn't have taken it.
I'll get him next time.
On reserves.
Shane, I need you to push up right about now. We're gonna do a bit of an experimental attack here. Get up on the roof, lob a grenade down the other end. See if I can take out the trooper. Yep.
Here, catch.
No more trooper. That's him down. Now you dash forward.
I'm almost there.
Just one demolitionist left. Is he going to run towards the next? Nope, he's not going to run. Interesting choice. My accuracy, though, is not that good. 49%. This time around, it does hit.
That's it.
Status confirmed. All hostiles are
excellent.
Down and the area is secure. Status confirmed. Mission
that was not as bad as I'd expected. Took down 17 aliens. Take note. 17. Mission 2. Now, normally, I believe you have about 8 targets on mission 2. And you do that with a 4-man squad. So the game basically doubled that. And you could argue that that creates a whole different power dynamic. Which I think you'd be right about. Okay, it's going to be promotions galore. Yes, you've seen that animation one mission at a time,
Commander. Impressive work.
This is my gunner, who did a fantastic job suppressing others. As you can see, normally you have two different options, now you have three. You can turn him into a saw gunner, which is a squad automatic weapon, or a machine gunner. Saw gunner is, in my opinion, the better alternative, because you get a shredder. And this means that you get rid of the enemy armor. Steady hands is more along the lines of creating this guy into a heavy machine gun operator, because this gives bonuses if you did not move him. I'm gonna go for shredder. Miss Cook is a trooper. Trooper is one of those soldiers who can fire their pistol and a main weapon in the same turn. Shock Trooper, this is the flamethrower guy. Morgan, Spec Ops. Spec Ops are pretty much my favorite class. They have throwing knives as well as the ability to take down enemies at very, very short range. Samurai, a pure melee specialist. If you have a look at the capabilities of this guy, he has Way of the Samurai. Intensive sword training adds plus 3 damage and plus 10 hit chance with swords, but comes with an aim penalty of minus 20. If you're gonna put a stock on anyone, it's gonna be this guy. Because he is just not good at hitting stuff. Because it may say aim 68, but when you're firing your main weapon, that should read aim 48. Miss King. Oh, this is good. She picked the exact right type for her stats. 78 aim on a squaddy, and she gets light him up, so she can fire twice. And then we have two further. We have one sharpshooter. A squaddy with a rate 82 aim. Holy shit. Steady weapon and the squad sight. Steady weapon, in case you're not familiar. It's where the sniper just does not move, or actually, no, you can have moved. Then you aim, or you steady your weapon, and you get further aim boosts next turn. And the last one is a shinobi. Shinobis are a mix between, reconnaissance and sword delivery attacks, or sword attacks. They get phantom, which means they stay concealed. They get flesh, or fleche, I'm never quite sure how to pronounce that. Attack any enemy within movement range with your sword. Deals plus 1 damage for every 3 tiles between your starting position and the target. So basically, the further you are away from the target, the more damage your attack will do. And finally, slash. Not at all a bad first operation. Or second, technically.
Hello, Commander. The council you once knew is no more. Its membership have all sworn loyalty to the Advent administration. With one exception. It is good to see you again. In the days since your capture, I have done all I can to aid the resistance from the inside. It was these resistance operatives that provided the intel leading to your recent extraction. As of now, resistance forces are currently somewhat disorganized. If we are to defeat Advent and their alien masters, you must change this before it is too late. What you are seeing are classified reports of missing civilians from across the world. Their numbers are growing. We suspect they have been taken to a nearby Advent black site, though its exact location remains unknown. Time is short, Commander. We need you to take charge of resistance operations throughout the world. Establish contact with the local cells and bring them into the fold. Find this black site and shut it down. Save our world. The clock is ticking. Good luck, Commander.
Thank you. We're gonna need that as well.
New objective added.
It looks like we've got our work cut out for us, Commander.
Another impressive effort, Commander. My expectations were high.
Great. We now have an engineer. We have absolutely no supplies. We have no guerrilla tactics school. and there's a lot of work to be done. That's the current state of affairs. But all of that we're going to be doing next episode. For now, I hope you enjoyed this one. I'll be back soon with more XCOM. I'm going to be aiming for 2 episodes a week. So with that, you can probably expect the next one Monday, on top of my head. And of course, if you're watching this video any later than the release date, then it's going to be up pretty much already. Anyway, thank you for watching. It's good to be back making videos again, and I hope to be seeing you very soon for more XCOM.